Okay, as you can see, I took the big centrepiece out of the tank for a while. I got up today and some of the fish were a bit pale or dark. And that one's just been a little bit under the weather all day, so I'm keeping a close eye on them, keeping the fish where I can see them at the minute without a little hiding place. I've done 2 25% water changes today and clean the filter, but I do that every week anyway, at least 1 25% water change in the filter. Little front hose is still doing lovely. But yeah, it just gives them a bit more room to move in and out the rocks now as well. So at the minute they're all schooling together. That's why the water's still a bit cloudy though, because like I've been doing water changes and kicked up the sand. Here's our new Corey. I still haven't figured out what type he is. I love his markings though, I think he's awesome. He keeps cleaning the big plaque as well. It's like little and large or something. Well yeah, I hope this guy gets well soon. And I hope they colour up again soon, the Lunacara. I don't seem to be having much luck with the Morais for some reason, I haven't got a bloody clue why. I'm doing the same thing I've done for years and years and years, but for some reason recently it just ain't working. We still got a little Morai fry in the other tank as well though. Sail fins up at the top, and then there's a big massive common, and then the albino common. But yeah, for now they're all schooling together and I'm not sure why, so I'm keeping an eye on that. Maybe it's because they're just getting used to the new layouts and the fact that they've had water changes, but water changes don't normally bother them, it's just part of the routine now. At least now I can see if it's free fighting or what, because like there's no hiding spots. So I'll have to keep you updated on that one. I know there hasn't been many updates this week, but I've been mad busy. The Oscar and the plaque are still doing fine in this tank. She's not going to be in there permanent. I'm still debating whether to buy her a bigger tank or whether to rehome her somewhere nice in a big tank. But for now she's got all the space she needs until I can sort something out. Because if she outgrew the tank I'd obviously move her, I wouldn't leave her in there. She gets more attention now she's in there, always getting little treats and stuff like mealworms. Because I pass this tank the most. and he's still out and about instead of hiding behind the filter all the time. That's the biggest of the albino commons that I've got. He's about 12, 13 inch now. This is the new bristlenose tank, there's one inside the ornament there. There's a male upside down under the bogwood and a little moray fry. There's another either male or female just wrapped off into the plant pot, and there's this female on the glass. And there's still loads of the little tiny albinos and dark ones. I just can't see where they are at the minute because there's that many places for them to hide. There's one down the back there. They all seem to be hiding. They are all in there and doing fine. As you can see, there's lots of places for little tiny plex to hide. There's another bigger one underneath that wood as well, hiding there for now. There's a little one on that filter, but I don't know if you can see or not. Glad being a bit busy on the back there. But yeah, at the minute it looks like that's all we're gonna get to see. Need to go in there and fish that poo out. Okay, at the minute I'm just watching this tank and hoping this little guy's alright. I'm wondering why they're all schooling together in one place in a tank that size. So both lights on the tank, I can dull it down by half as well. This is how I normally film, so I can zoom in further on the fish. With only one of the lights on. So yeah, hopefully the Corys and stuff will encourage them to spread out a bit more. I suppose they also need to find new territories after they took the centrepiece out though.